In 1883, an avalanche of hot debris destroys everything in its path for miles around. Nothing, not even open water, can stop it. Then the volcano enters its deadliest phase.
The original island of Krakatoa had three large peaks. Before the explosion in 1883, and the first monster explosion most likely removed the tops of both of these. And then the monster of all explosions at 10:02 in the morning that darkened the skies. It shattered windows and walls in the nearby villages. The largest sound ever heard in human history. Just colossal explosion. And it went like this. Boom!
The buried balloon was the volcano's magma chamber. After the eruption, so much magma had been ejected from below, Krakatoa collapsed in on itself. It sent an island of rock crashing into the sea. It formed a huge volcanic basin, or caldera, now hidden beneath the ocean.
This caldera is right out there, and that's what I'm gonna go take a look at. I'm gonna free dive right over here. With no scuba tanks or big heavy weights, and you can really get the full experience. Let's go check it out. Here we go.
The ocean floor in this region is generally flat and shallow. But as I dive down, I come across a massive underwater cliff that cuts sharply into the seabed. This is the edge of the caldera.
Oh, it's like an Eden down there. And the side wall, it just goes vertical. It's like standing in a room looking at a wall. It's almost like the sirens just calling me to go deeper. Because if I get down to see what I really want to see, I might not be able to make it all the way back up. It's just breathtaking. But I have to go check it out again.
The cliff is one side of a giant hole in the sea floor. It's the remains of the volcano's magma chamber, now collapsed into a huge caldera. I'm actually diving inside the remains of an old volcano.
That's as deep as I can go. I just started to make out the bottom. The visibility is unreal. It's like being in a swimming pool, and that wall just keeps dropping straight down. In the 19th century, where I'm diving, there was a mountaintop 2,600 feet above me, and I went about 60 feet down. Could barely make out the ground.
The scale of the caldera is stunning. A hole over half a mile deep and 5 miles wide gouged into the ocean floor. But take a look at the map again.
Sea charts show a faint outline of what some scientists think is a caldera from the 535 eruption. It's 10 times bigger than the one Martin's just seen. A land collapse on that scale would displace millions of gallons of water, unleashing a series of raging tsunamis.